Hi, welcome to the Ask Patrick series. Today's question is by Parth Shah. Basic question is, how do I score 35 plus in CET cons, in this con section of CET? Con section of CET is up to 50 marks. Now the issue with the con section of CET is it has been varying quite a bit. Some years the DI has been tough, some years the quant has been tough, some years the whole section has been easy. So it's very difficult to keep a target when the difficulty level varies. Also very difficult to keep a target when there's no time limits per section. Technically, if I feel a con section very tough, I'll give less time to cons and give more time to other section, in which case my score will in cons will go down. Vice versa, if my con section is easy as compared to other sections, I will spend more time on cons and less on other time sections. So in which case I'll score more in cons. So yes, you need to be a little flexible when you're planning a strategy for a particular section as far as CET is concerned, mainly because of the lack of time limit per section. So in that case, the flexibility will depend on the difficulty level of each section in the examination. You may spend more time on a section which is easier and which you're comfortable with, and maybe less time on a section which is really tough. So even if you're very good at cons and a con comes really tough, it may make sense to not spend too much time on con section. But yes, coming to the whole fact of scoring a 35 plus, look at the major areas of con section in the CET exam. If you look at, there is almost 20 to 24 marks of data interpretation, which is a big, big part of the paper. Usually two sets of DI is normally easy. One could be tough. Do you need to figure it out whether I should be able to solve it or leave it? Okay, same with cons. Cons is another major portion. Though the syllabus is vast, there are only 14, 15 questions of cons. The first major section is the DI, next is quant, and then look at the other sections which are there. There is quadratic, there is comparisons, there is DS, there is calculations. So these are small sets that come for 4-5 questions. Be comfortable with it. I mean, whatever has come in the past CET examinations, the type of questions, be really comfortable with it. So that if those type of questions come, you should be comfortably able to solve it. That's one way of trying to be good at CET, is to be comfortable with whatever comes in the, whatever is known and has come in the CET in the past. So that's how you practice and then try to improve. And last but not the least, the important factor is the score you try to get per minute. So for every part of the con section, try to figure out your marks per minute. For example, a quadratic equation, if I have a set of 5 questions, how much marks can I get if I solve everything and how much time do I take? Same with maybe DI, same with con. Try to figure out how much marks you get per minute and see which type of question you should solve and which type to leave. So wherever you get high marks per minute, you will solve it. Wherever you get low marks per minute, you leave it. And that is a strategy followed throughout the CET sections, all the sections of CET. Use that. I'm sure it will help you to prioritize what sections to solve and what part not to solve. And that will help you to maximize the overall scope. Hope that helps. Thank you.